Hi everyone, my name is Kerem Yücetürk. I'm a program manager working on Microsoft Search in OneDrive and SharePoint. I'm recording this from Seattle, Washington, near Microsoft headquarters.
Hi everyone, I'm Tanuja Pridarshini. I'm a program manager working on Microsoft Search, and today I'm joining from Oslo, Norway.
In this video, we will be looking at how Microsoft Search is built into SharePoint and OneDrive for Business, and how it helps users to get to the content and people they're looking for with confidence. First, a few words on Microsoft Search. The goal of Microsoft Search is to connect you to the knowledge and expertise in your organization and help you be more productive, take action, and save time. To make this possible, it is readily available across all Microsoft 365 apps without requiring any setup, with the consistently placed search box on top of each app. As you work, Microsoft Search is aware of who you work with, files you work on, sites you frequent, and uses this intelligence to bring you results that are personalized to you when you do a search. And with additional small investments, it lets you add even more value for your users through addition of answers, bringing in content from outside of Microsoft 365, and building custom solutions. We will look at three main scenarios through the demos you're about to see. First, we will see how Microsoft Search lets you search across all of the information in your organization and beyond, including finding content through people. Then we will see how a similar experience is available in SharePoint Sites and highlight some new capabilities there. And finally, we will look at some of the new search capabilities in OneDrive for Business. Let's begin with Microsoft Search for your whole organization.
Here I am in the SharePoint Start page, and I have company news, my frequent and recent sites, all at my fingertips. So from here, let's dig into search. This search box, which gives me a consistent entry point into Microsoft Search, gives me results drawn from files, sites, people, news from my organization, and they're always personalized to me. And in this auto suggest pane, I have query suggestions from my own query history, which makes it really easy to repeat any of my previous queries. Let's start with a simple search. Using these links at the top, I can navigate to different verticals. I can pivot my result set to see either only files or only sites results, only people, and so on. We are also working on adding new out-of-the-box verticals to represent more content types, for instance, images and Power BI reports. And you also have the ability to bring in your own external data sources using connectors and add custom verticals. Coming back to all, when we scan this result set, this is actually a heterogeneous list with a mix of different content types. And we have improved filtering capabilities to let you slice and dice this result set and refine it as you wish. Okay, moving on. Say I have recently started ramping up on a new project on accessibility. Okay, I reshoot my search, but looks like I misspelled it. But luckily for me, I'm getting some help here, and I can click on this suggested spell correction to issue the right query right away. This first result here is a bookmark link promoted by the IT admin. And these answers give admins an easy way to put authoritative content in front of their users. And as I scan the result set, I see some unfamiliar terms like RPA, QT, and so on. Often at work, we come across acronyms like this, and these terms could mean something very specific to a project or an organization. So what I can do at this point is to try to find the meaning of this in the form of a question. Right, I get an acronym answer back with a set of expansions. And these meanings are mined from content that you have access to, and the admins can curate these as well. You also have the option of sending feedback on this on a specific answer using these links at the bottom. This way. Now moving on to another project that I'm working on. This is codenamed Mark 8. So I'm going to issue my query. As we were just talking about bookmark answers, seeing this top result here just reminds me that it would be great if this was promoted as a bookmark, because then anybody who searches for Mark 8 project would be able to find it as the authoritative link. So I can start by getting the link, and then I can use the general feedback option at the top right corner of the result page to suggest this as a bookmark link to my IT admin. And this dialog gives you a set of other options as well. And your admins will have the option of forwarding this feedback to Microsoft as well. Great, coming back to the results, you might notice that we have placed a list of people right next to the main results. This is a new capability we're adding in Microsoft Search. The rationale behind this is when we talk to our users, when we look at the common search patterns, we see that people often use different signals or connections from their work to navigate their organizational content. And one such cue that's commonly used by people is actually people. We tend to recall things by, for instance, who shared it, who was working on this, or who presented it. And in this case, I see that all of them have contributed to the topic Mark 8. But if I want to dig into, say, Emily's work, I can select her from this list. And now I'm in this mode, which is focused around Emily's work. Using this people-centric search pattern, I can zoom in on a person to view, explore, and search the enterprise graph around them. I can refine this view as I wish. I can use filters, and I can also refine the query here. So Emily, I see that she's a budget analyst. Maybe I'm interested in seeing what she has been writing about budget lately. Great, now I get new results. Again, focused on Emily's work, but this time with a different query. We have placed the key profile information right here. I can easily contact her or contextualize who she is. I can also use these links at the top to understand more about the person. In this case, I can see Emily's skills, expertise, project she is working on, and I can place her in the organization and see calendar information. I can get to the same experience directly from the search box as well. Say I search for Alex, and from the auto suggest pane, I select Alex from the people suggestions, and I select that. Now I'm in the same mode, but this time focused around Alex's work. These are the same type of people cards that you're familiar with from Office 365. In a way, we are combining the power of Microsoft Search and people experiences to give you the right tools to search with confidence. Before wrapping up this section, just wanted to emphasize that all these features that we just went through from SharePoint homepage should be available in your SharePoint home site as well. So this is the home site of Contoso Electronics, and I should have the same functionality from this endpoint as well. For instance, if I'm able to find a warehouse location from the home site, I should have the same functionality when I'm in Microsoft Search in Bing and when I'm searching in office.com. So to summarize, we just went through a bunch of Microsoft Search features that we're adding to the company-wide global search endpoints, where you can get personalized results from content across the organization. And we also highlighted the new people-centric search capabilities, and there's improvements in filtering. You can add custom filters, you can add custom verticals. You can also bring in external content using connectors. You can use this link to learn more about the customization scenarios. Let's move on to some more Microsoft Search features we are adding in SharePoint Sites. Right, going back to where I left off, I'm going to find the site that I want to visit from the search box in office.com. Let's see. It's called Communications. This looks like the right one. This is a SharePoint communication site. It's a site associated with the global marketing hub site, and you see the hub navigation at the top here. So whenever I search from here, my search box is contextualized to this site, and by default, I will get results from just this site rather than the whole organization. But what's new here is this dropdown that we have added in the search box. Using these links, I can either broaden my search to all associated sites of this hub, or I can broaden it all the way to the whole organization as well. So here I have results from the communication site and from this results page. In addition to the dropdown that we just looked at, I also have these links at the top that I can use to expand my searches. So this gives me a great tool to broaden my searches to the required level, either to the hub level or to look in the whole organization and search with confidence.
In SharePoint sites, document libraries and lists are some of the most frequently used features. And in these scenarios, Microsoft Search is there to help. Here I am in a document library in a different site, and I can see the search box on top of my page. When I click in it, I can see that I'm actually searching across the current library, but I can use this dropdown to change where I'm searching to current site or the whole organization. If I go into a folder in my library, this happens to be a folder that's connected to a channel in Microsoft Teams. Now my search is scoped to that folder. So if I do my search, I will get back my results for the items that matched the content or the file names in that folder. I can use this link to go up a level to search across the whole library, and even use this link to further expand my search to all items in this site. Now let's take a look at a list. So here I have a list that shows the upcoming bills for Contoso, and it has some nice column formatting applied to it as well. And Microsoft Search is in the same location that I saw it in the document libraries. When I click on it, I can go ahead and search for something. And anything that matches in that list is going to come back as a search result, along with the column formatting still applied to the search results. And if I click on this link, now I can see all of the items that match across my site. In addition to the list items, I can see files, news stories, etc. And with one more click, I can expand my search to my whole organization. We just saw how Microsoft Search is present in SharePoint sites, letting you search in the context of that site, including in lists and libraries. We also saw that if the site you are in happens to be associated with a hub site, how you can easily search across all the sites in the hub or the whole organization from where you are. Using the dropdown in the search box and the links on the search results page, I always know where I'm searching and how I can look broader if I don't see what I was looking for in that location. Finally, let's take a look at OneDrive for Business. OneDrive is the app for all your files, wherever they may be. And Microsoft Search lets you find the content you're looking for across all of the files and folders you have access to using the search box in OneDrive. In OneDrive, when you do a search like this, you get results from all of the organization in a way that's personally relevant for you. So these items coming back may be in your from your personal drive, in a folder that was shared with you in someone else's drive, in a library, in a SharePoint site that you're a member of, or shared in a Teams channel that you happen to be in. I can see where a result is coming from in this updated location column. And I can even select the result and jump to that file location if I choose to. If I know what I'm looking for is in my drive, I can use the dropdown in the search box to change where I'm searching to only look there. And if I'm browsing a folder, let's go to My Files and find this special project folder. When I do a search, it is actually scoped to that current folder. And it will bring back results from any subfolders in that folder, as well as anything that matches in that folder. Now I can use the links here again to go broader to My Files and to all files across my organization. Another way to search a specific location is to use the shared libraries. If I click on the library that we were just on earlier, I can see the same library set up with all of its columns in front of me, and I can browse to a folder, and the dropdown in the search box lets me know where exactly I'm searching. So now I'm doing the same search directly from within my OneDrive and getting back results from all of these locations directly where I am. To summarize, OneDrive is the app for all your files, and Microsoft Search is there to search across these files wherever they may be. And now you can search in specific folders or shared libraries directly using the dropdown built into the search box. If you're on the go, SharePoint and OneDrive mobile apps also have Microsoft Search built in. Just tap into the search box in these apps and find the results that you're looking for. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Search, we have more videos available. Go to the tech community and find Microsoft Search to access all of this content, and follow us on Twitter @MicrosoftSearch for latest search announcements. Thank you for watching.